Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to easily Photoshop wheels on your car using just your cell phone. So I see people use visualizers like this one from various websites to try and get an idea of what wheels will look like on their vehicle, and while they're nice to have, they aren't the most realistic. I'm going to show you a method I've been using for a while that you can do right on your cell phone to give you a more realistic idea of what wheels will look like on your actual vehicle. First, you need to have a photo of your vehicle that you want to use, like this one, and then do a Google image search of the specific wheels that you're looking for. The good news is, unless they're brand new wheels, you're likely to be able to find a photo you can use. In my case, I ultimately found a photo of a Tesla Model 3 with the same wheels I was looking at. Now, it's important that the photos be at a similar angle because we're going to basically copy the wheels from the photo you find to your vehicle. Here's how. The app I mainly use for this is called InCollage. You can see it has millions of downloads and is very highly rated. I actually use it for a variety of things, but it works very well for this purpose. When you open up the app, there are several things you can do, but we want to go to Edit and select the base photo. Then we'll scroll over on the bottom to Add and select the photo with the wheels. You can see it now overlays that photo on your base photo. And this photo should work well with my photo here. Now with that photo selected, we're going to tap crop and crop it down to one of the wheels. I'm going to start with the front here. The idea here is to get it close so we have less erasing to do. Once it's cropped, we can drag the bottom corner of the photo to make it larger, and then we'll tap the eraser button to bring up that tool. I adjust it to the maximum size and then start erasing. When you tap, the eraser is a little above where you tap, so you can see what you're erasing, which is nice. And I'm going to go around the wheel and erase everything other than the wheel itself. Now, if you go through and accidentally erase too much, like I did here, you can tap the undo button at the top and try again. You want to try and get as close as possible. Then once you're done erasing, the Tesla was facing the opposite direction, so I need to correct the orientation. At the bottom, I'm going to tap horizontal to flip the wheel image horizontally, and then now I'm going to adjust the size and rotation to overlay it on my wheel. It may take a few tries to get it the exact right size and position, but this is important to get it to look as realistic as possible. Then once that's done, we'll do the same thing on the rear. We'll go to Add, select the photo again, crop it down to the wheel we're looking at. We'll enlarge it and erase the excess. In this case, since it was smaller, I'm going to erase the excess, then enlarge it again and get closer to the wheel itself. Then I'm going to flip it horizontally and adjust its size and rotation. And then once that's good, we need to fix the lighting to better match the base photo. So I'm going to tap the wheels, and then tap filter to bring up those settings, and then adjust the brightness and the contrast. And that looks better. Now that looks pretty good, but I'm going to do a little bit more. For my photo, I'm not a fan of the color of the tires. There's kind of a purplish tint on them from the sky that isn't on the wheels, so it looks a little off. So I'm going to open the image I just saved in the Snapseed app, another good photo editing app. I'm going to zoom in a little bit and go to Tools and tap Brush, and then go to Saturation and adjust it to reduce the saturation, and then drag over the tires themselves to reduce that purplish tint. And then I can adjust the photo itself to make it more cohesive as well. And then I'm going to save that. And the last thing I'm going to do is fix a little bit where the old wheels are actually showing still slightly on the rear. To do that, I'm going to open up my Samsung Gallery editing app on my phone. Then I'm going to go to the draw tool and draw over those light portions where my old wheels are still showing. Now, this isn't required, but it definitely helps. And that's it. This is the finished product. Looks pretty realistic to me and definitely gives me a good representation of what those wheels would look like on my actual vehicle sitting in my driveway. So anyway, just wanted to share this with you guys. I think it definitely can be helpful and doesn't take much time at all. Let me know your thoughts, and if you have any questions on this, I'll be glad to help. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for more videos. I have a lot on the way, so stay tuned. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.